What's going on, guys? Class meeting today, and we'll give everybody a few minutes to get in. If you're in already, go ahead and check in the comment section. Go to the comment section. You can write over here. Just type "I'm here." I'll type "hello" in here. That way I know that everybody knows how to use this meeting chat. So you can ask questions while we go along. And I am going to stop us in a minute to ask questions, or every few minutes we're going to stop and answer a few questions. And we keep going like that. All right, so we'll give everybody a couple of minutes to get in. While we're waiting, does anybody have any questions about what we have so far, or what's going on so far? Can you see me? Can you hear me well? Go ahead and type in the chat if you can. Say yes, no. I guess if you're replying, then I know you can hear me. As normal, we're going to start with the sixth grade, and then we're going to move on to the seventh and eighth grade. So if you're in seventh and eighth grade, you want to hang on for a few minutes so that we can get sixth grade done with. Okay, we're going to go ahead and get started here in just a few seconds. Again, if you have any questions while you're waiting, just go ahead and type that in there. I have a lot of questions coming from you guys about things that we've already went over. For example, I've got people in the chat asking where the meeting is, and the meeting's been in the same spot every time. And it comes to your email. Okay. Sent the email to everybody. All right. All right, so let me do this. All right, so there'll be a video of it. Okay, so sixth grade. For the sixth grade, let me share my screen with you guys. And let me get into it. All right. So for the sixth grade, it keeps switching back. All right, for the sixth grade, let me go into one of the sixth grade classes. Okay. All right, in the sixth grade classes, you're going to be working on a commercial script. All right, so what you need to do is you need to go up to assignments. Once you get into Microsoft Teams, click on your class, go to assignments, and your assignment is here, commercial script. So once you click on commercial script, I'm going to go to student view so you can see what's going on. Today you're going to be creating a script for your very own commercial. You'll sell a product or service to the class. Use your imagination to come up with an awesome commercial. Remember, you'll be shooting and editing this commercial, so create a script that you can shoot at home, okay? Now, you won't be creating this right now. You're going to do the script first, and then next week, I'm going to assign the shooting portion. Now, don't get ahead of yourself and start shooting, because there's some specific instructions that you're going to need to know as far as the shooting goes. So if you shoot a commercial and you turn it in, it's probably not going to be what is expected of you. So you need to wait for the rubric. All right, so here's kind of a small rubric on what you need. You create an existing product or service, all right, and then you will sell your service or product to the class via a commercial. All right, the product or service can be real or fake, and the commercial must be at least 15 seconds and no longer than 60 seconds. All right, you're going to tell us what the product is, how it benefits the person, what problem does it solve, and how much does it cost. Okay. Simple enough. So what you're going to do is you're going to go grab that template again for the AV script. Okay, so you click here and it should take you to this page. Once you get to this page, click on the script template, and that's your template for your script. All right. Let me see if I can pull up this here. All right. Hold on for just a second. All right, let me see if I can share this document with you. Yes. Let me go to my pages. Okay. I want to share this document with you. All right, this is the document that you're going to be using to write your script. Now, let's go over what we did last week, or what you should have done last week. Some of you turned it in, some of you didn't. And a lot of you are asking a lot of questions about what we have going on, and I'm making videos about it. And you guys are screaming, you don't understand. And we have videos, we have written instruction, and I'm helping you. But no one's showing up to the class meetings. So we got to do a better job with showing up to the class meetings if you don't understand something, right? And not just give up. If you give up now, you're going to be giving up the rest of your life, and you don't want to be doing it. You don't want to be one of those people that do that, all right? So this is what you want to do. In your video portion, you're going to write what you see. So for example, last week we talked about the cats, right? Or we had this dialogue for cats, all right? So let's take a look at that. You won't be able to see this come up, but you can follow along on the video here. All right. So last week we had the assignment of creating or going through your Nearpod and creating a script. So let's look at that. All right. So we had this thing that says cats playing with yarn, cats playing in a house made for cats. Cats mixed up and tangled in yarn. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to copy this, and I'm going to paste it right here. Okay, so this is my video portion of my script. All right. All right. So when I get into these scripts, everything on the video side is what you will actually see on TV. So if you see a cat playing with yarn, if we have a video of a cat playing with yarn, what we're going to put on the audio side is something like this. Many cats love to play with yarn. Okay? Many cats love to play with yarn. So while I'm saying that, this is what you're going to be hearing the person say. But while you're watching the TV screen, you'll be seeing this. Cats playing with yarn, okay? So many cats love to play with yarn. All right, and then my next sentence may be something still dealing with yarn. The yarn gets tangled up on the cats, okay? Whatever. So what I wanna do is, I'm gonna copy this, I'm gonna delete it. The next thing I wanna put in is the cats mixed up and tangled in yarn. So as I'm saying, the yarn gets tangled up on the cats. On the video side, we're gonna type in cats mixed up and tangled in yarn because that is what we're gonna be seeing on the TV screen. Everybody get it? All right. Now, if you don't get it, please ask a question inside of the chat. And the last example was, let's see, cats playing in a house made for cats. So my next audio may be these two cats love to play in their home, their own little cat home, okay? And then you'll see cats playing in a house made for cats, okay? So that's how you do that. Now, let's say, for example, we're going to start working on our script for our commercial. So let's say I'm selling, I don't know, a hair product. Let's say I'm selling shampoo, okay? So I'm going to say, I'm going to give an example of what? Let's go back and look at the assignment. Tell us what the product is. Do you have tangled hair? Well, shampoo 2000. So in the video, I might want to put person struggling with tangled hair, okay? Then I might want to show the product. Shampoo product on the shelf, all right? Does that make sense? That should make sense to everybody. So you see how I'm going? I'm writing a portion of my script. All right, do you have tangled hair? Well, shampoo 3000 will help you get rid of that tangled mess. So I'm telling you what I have, what the product is. I'm telling you what the problem is and how to solve, how this problem can be solved, okay? That's what I mean in that section where I was telling you how to get, what are you supposed to do as far as solving a problem and showing what the problem is. All right, so that should be clear enough for you guys. You guys are smart enough to understand what's going on there. Okay, if you have any more questions, then please send me an email, and this video will also be posted on the page again, so you can go back and watch this. All right, I'm going to give you a few seconds to ask some questions in here. It's 2:15, so if you have any questions, go ahead and ask them now in the chat section while I get set up for seventh and eighth grade. So if seventh and eighth graders, just hold off for a second and get ready to get to you. Sixth graders, you guys are good to go if you are finished. If not, then ask questions. Stick around for a few more minutes. I'm gonna go ahead and get set up with seventh and eighth grade. Any questions? Any questions? Go into Teams really quick, and I'm going to post this link again. All right. I see some of you asking where the meeting is after there's been an email sent out. So I'm just going to assume maybe I didn't do something right. And what I'm going to send it to my eighth grade classes, because I'm getting ready to start with eighth grade here. Do that, all of the classes were invited as well. I can see it here. Okay. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get started with seventh and eighth grade. All right, again, if you have any questions, use the comment section so that we can get those questions answered. All right, so seventh and eighth grade, we are going to take a look inside of our screen here. Now, seventh and eighth grade, you guys have to watch this video back. If you're not watching now, you have to watch this video back. And I'll post that in the chat and everything as well. You have to watch this video back because we're going over some stuff that you guys are going to need to know to answer to do this music video project. All right, so you're going to be doing a music video project. We're going to start it. Okay, the first thing we need to do is we need to plan for our music video. But in order to plan, we are going to have to understand a few things about music video. So I'm going to go through a short PowerPoint presentation. It's only four slides, so you won't get bored, I promise you. All right. So I am going to share this with you, okay? I hate that it does that. All right, so we're going to go through this. Music videos. All right. Music video, there's two main components in the music video. One is your performance. The second one is your B-roll. All right, let's take a look at performance. In your performance, the artist is actually performing the song. So this is the part of the song where you actually see their mouth moving and actually speaking or lip syncing the words. All right, this is not a dance routine. This is not anything other than when you see the person actually lip syncing the words. That is what we call a performance scene. Although A dance routine is a performance. It is not considered a performance scene. So when we start talking about, or we start doing our performance shots, do not incorporate a dance scene in your performance shots, okay? This is going to be for your actual lip syncing, all right? Now, you're going to definitely need help with this as we move forward, but I got some ideas for you and you guys are going to be fine, trust me, all right? So this is for lip syncing the words. And now there's different locations that people are going to use when they do their actual lip sync, okay? And you're going to be using a bunch of different locations as well. I'll probably limit it to about 2 or 3. All right, so you're going to do, that is your performance scene. So let's take a look at, really quick, what a performance scene would look like. Okay, now I want to show you a video that you probably have already seen before. So don't get mad. All right, and I hope this is the right one. I think it might be a spoof. Okay. All right. So as you can see, this is Lil Nas X, his Old Town Road video, okay? So we're gonna be looking for a performance scene. Yeah, and it should come up really quick right here. All right, right here is that performance scene, okay? Why? Because he was actually lip syncing the words. All right, that part is your performance scene. That's what a performance scene is, okay? All right, now moving forward, we're gonna go over back to our PowerPoint here. All right, and we're gonna go to B-roll. This is the second component of music video, all right? B-roll is video that helps tell your story, okay? It's that video that helps tell your story. So if you watch some of these music videos and you've seen these kind of like stories that go on in the background while the person is actually singing or rapping or whatever they're doing, that is what they call B-roll. Most of the time that B-roll is in slow motion, all right? And for your slow motion, you're gonna have to change your frame rate. We'll get into that in just a second. We're gonna go over it more the next time we meet, okay? All right, so B-roll. So let's take a look at an example of what B-roll may look like. I'm gonna go back here and share again. I'm gonna go over to this. And I'm gonna put it up for you. All right, so B-roll. All right, B-roll is that footage, all the other footage that is not the actual singer or the rapper doing the actual word, okay? So let's take a look at what B-roll may look like. That here is B-roll there. That's your performance scene because he's actually saying something or mouthing something. All right, this here is B-roll. Why? Because he's not saying anything. We're just seeing scenes that are helping telling his story, okay? All of this stuff is help telling the story. This is performance. This is B-roll. That's performance because he's actually singing. All right, B-roll here. Good, all right. That's enough, everybody understand that. All right, if you have questions, again, go ahead and type them over here in the chat. All right. Now, let's go back to our PowerPoint so we can see what is going on here. Okay, so we're back on our PowerPoint. All right, so that was an example of your B-roll. Shows exactly what B-roll is. Now, let's go to frame rate. Now, it's a lot of stuff here. So let's talk about frame rate. Video cameras don't take video. I know you're probably saying, Mr. Harper, you're wrong, but actually, I'm correct. Video cameras don't take video. They take pictures, and they just add audio to the pictures, okay? Each picture that the camera takes is a frame, okay? So video cameras actually just takes a bunch of pictures in succession, and those pictures together create a motion picture or a frame or a frame rate or 1 second of video, okay? So if you heard of the term motion pictures, that's what we're talking about, all right? So we deal in frames per second. Most of the time when you're watching TV, they're either in 30 or 60 frames per second. So that means you'll get 30 frames per 1 second of video or 30 pictures per 1 second of video. So have you guys have probably seen a flip book? And when you get a flip book, you open it to the first page and you start flipping through and things look like as if they're moving. That's the same thing a video camera does. All it does is take a bunch of pictures. That's why we have picture cameras now that people are starting using these digital SLRs, digital cameras that photographers use to do video, because people got smart and they were like, well, we can serve the video community and the photography community with one tool, all right? Because all it's doing is taking pictures, all right? All right, so performance scenes are shot in 24 frames a second. That's the film frame rate, all right? When you go watch a movie, movies are shot in 24 frames a second, all right? Back in the day, they used to have those big rolls of film, and those big rolls of film would go through those cameras at 24 frames. That's why we got the film look, okay? All right, and your B-roll is gonna be shot in 60 to 240 frames per second or more. So the higher the frame rate, the smoother your slow motion is gonna be. You can do slow motion at 24 frames, but it's gonna look really choppy and really nasty, all right? But if you do it at 60, at least 60 frames a second, it's gonna be smooth, okay? You may not be able to slow it down really, really slow, but you can slow it down enough so it'll be a good, nice, smooth, slow motion. All right, the higher you go, the slower you can slow your footage down to get nice, just smooth, slow motion. Now, there's some cameras that can go all the way up to 1,000 frames per second, okay? You're gonna spend about the price of a car for those, about $30,000 to $40,000. But anywhere between 60 and 120 frames, you're gonna spend anywhere from $500 to probably $3,500. All right, to get a camera like that. Okay. So what we have to worry about really is our performance scenes, because that's the next thing we're going to be focusing on. We're going to break this stuff down. All right. First thing we're going to do is be working on performance scenes. That's going to start next week, next Thursday. We're going to start doing that. All right. This week, you're going to create a proposal for your music video. Okay. So let me go into this really quick so I can show you exactly what you're going to be doing. All right. Now, the proposal sheet is going to look exactly or similar to the other one that we had. All right. Now, all of you should have had my class last year. If not, you can just email me and we can walk you through what to do here. Now, I've saved you some time because you normally would have to do a, and this should not be there. Normally you would have to do pre-production documents. I've created a document that's going to give you all of your pre-production documents, or most of your pre-production documents, all in one. All right. So since you're doing a music video, you don't have to worry about actually doing a script. So you're going to do a treatment. And instead of doing a formal treatment, you're going to do this proposal, and that's going to serve as your treatment. Okay. So this is what you're going to have to do for this week. You're going to put your project title, yourself, your name, And they're gonna come up with an idea, make sure that it can be done at home. Make sure that the song you pick is school appropriate, doesn't have any cursing, so do the clean versions. Okay. What is your concept? All right, so the concept of, if I had a video and I was doing a video for the Migos, for their motorsport video, I would have had them racing Lamborghinis through Tokyo. So that would be my concept. We're gonna be racing Lamborghinis through Tokyo. All right, your concept for a music video might just be a total dance video. All right, where you'll be dancing and then doing your performance scene separate, okay? Then you're gonna summarize your scenes below. What is scene one gonna look like? What is your location that you have? All right, location 1, 2, 3. All right, what is your background gonna look like? Okay, so come up with an idea for that. Okay, what locations do you want to use? You must choose 3. All right, it says the classroom because we use this in school, but one location could be your bedroom. The next location could be in your backyard. The next location could be in your kitchen. All right. So 3 different locations. All right. You must have 3 different shots at each location. So right here, you're gonna create a plan for those shots. All right. Write the location first, shot type, whatever. So shot 1 might be in your kitchen. All right, and you want to do a long shot in your kitchen. All right. All right. And then your scene would be performance scene. Your scene 2, all right, your shot number 2 is still in your kitchen, and then you want to do a medium shot. Shot 3 could still be in your kitchen, and you want to do a close up. So do 3 different ones. So do long shot, medium shot, close up. If you follow that format, you'll be fine. Long shot, medium shot, close up. All right, for those 3, and then do performance, performance, performance. All right, then you go to the next location. Backyard, long shot, medium shot, close up. All right, should make sense. And you keep going on and on and on until you finish this shot list. Okay, so you have a treatment and a shot list, and that's all of your pre-production. All right, all of your pre-production will be done as soon as you finish this and turn it in. All right, then after that, next week, you'll get the instructions on how to start shooting your performance scenes, so forth and so on. Okay, of course you're going to turn that in as normal. All right, under here it should say add work button. Click the add work, submit it, and you should be good. Okay, now does anybody have any questions? You can type in the chat box here and I'll answer those questions. We've actually gone a little bit over our time, but I'll sit here for a few minutes and wait on you guys to ask questions. So if you have questions, go ahead and type in the meeting chat box. There's a little, I don't know what it looks like on your screen, but there is a little chat button up top. So if you have any questions, type in the chat box. If not, you are good to go. All right, so that is the end, guys. I'm going to post this on the pages, and I will talk to you on next Thursday, if not before. All right.